All right, so we've defined our terms. We know what it takes to do at least supervised learning. And so now I want to do a specific algorithm and a specific representation that allows us to solve the problem of going from instances to actual concepts. So what we're going to talk about next are decision trees. And I think the best way to introduce decision trees is through an example. So here's the very simple example I want you to think about for a while. You're on a date with someone. And you come to a restaurant, and you're going to try to decide whether to enter the restaurant or not. So your input, your instances, are going to be features about the restaurant. And we'll talk a little bit about what those features might be. And the output is whether you should enter or not. Okay, so it's a very simple, straightforward problem. But there are a lot of details here that we have to figure out.
It's a classification problem.
It's clearly a classification problem because the output is yes, we should enter, or no, we should move on to the next restaurant. So in fact, it's not just a classification problem. It's those binary classification problems that I said that we'd almost exclusively be thinking about for the next few minutes. Okay. So you understand the problem setup?
Yes, though I'm not sure exactly what the pieces of the input are.
Right. So that's actually the right next question to ask. We have to actually be specific now about a representation. Before, I was drawing squiggly little lines, and you could imagine what they were. But now, since we're really going to go through an example, we need to be clear about what does it mean to be standing in front of a restaurant. So let's try to figure out how we would represent that and how we would define that. We're talking about you're standing in front of a restaurant, or eatery, because I can't seem to reliably spell restaurant, and we're going to try to figure out whether we're going to go in or not. But what do we have to describe our eatery? What do we have? What are our attributes? What are the instances actually made of? So another way of putting it is, what are the features that we need to pay attention to that are going to help us to determine whether we should, yes, enter into the restaurant, or no, move on to the next restaurant? So any ideas, Michael?
Sure. I guess there's like the type of restaurant.
Okay.
So is it tall or short, and is it a good credit risk? Oh, wait, no, wait, no, I know, Italian versus French versus, you know, Vietnamese.
So let's call that the type. So it could be Italian, it could be French, it could be Thai, it could be American. They're American restaurants, right?
Sure.
Greek, it can be Armenian, it can be any kind of restaurant you want to. Okay, good. So that's something that probably matters because maybe you don't like Italian food or maybe you really are in the mood for Thai. Sounds perfect. Okay, anything else?
Sure. How about whether it smells good?
Yeah, I like cleanliness. Let's be nice to our eateries and let's say atmosphere.
Mm. Right, because if there's, you know, no atmosphere, then it's going to be really hard to breathe.
That's exactly right. So is it fancy? Is it a hole in the wall? Which I'm going to spell H-I-W. Is it a hole in the wall? Those sorts of things, you know.
Casual, I guess, is another category.
Casual. And so on and so forth. You can imagine lots of things like that, but these things might matter to you and your date. Okay, so we know the type of restaurant that we have. We know whether it's fancy, whether it's casual, whether it's a hole in the wall. Some of the best food I've ever had are in, you know, well-known hole in the walls. Those sorts of things. Anything else you can think of?
Sure. Sometimes I might use something like looking inside and seeing whether there's people in there, whether they look like they're having a good time.
Right. So that's an important thing. So let's just say if it's occupied. Now, why might that matter in reality? Well, it matters because if it's completely full and you may have to wait for a very long time, you might not want to go in. On the other hand, if you're looking at a restaurant you've never heard of and there's only two people in it and it's Friday at 7 p.m., maybe that says something about something. So maybe you want it to be quiet. You know, those sorts of things might matter. Okay, so we've got type, we've got atmosphere, we've got occupied. Anything else you can think of?
I have been out of the dating market for a while, but I guess I could imagine how hard I am trying to work to impress my date.
Ah, perfect. So do you have a hot date or not? Or this is someone you really, really, really want to impress, and so maybe it matters then. It's even more important whether it's a fancy restaurant or a hole in the wall, or whether it's French, or whether it's an American restaurant. That makes sense? I think that makes sense. Notice, by the way, that the first two sets that we have multiple possible categories here. So they could be Italian, French, Thai, American, so on and so forth. Atmosphere is something that can have many, many possible values. But the last two things that we talked about were all binary. Either it's occupied or it's not. yes or no, or you have a hot date or you don't. And I think we could go on like this for a long time. But let's try to move on to maybe a couple of other features and then try to actually figure out how we might solve this.